Welcome to third part of writing a policy brief and then converting it into a legislation. As part of public policy, an introduction, a program of MOOC, MOOC. In the last two episodes, we understood what is the policy brief, how it emerges out of a problem that is faced by the society, and how does it get transformed into a policy by the cabinet of the government that is ruling a particular part of the state. Now, if the implementation of the policy which was evolved out of policy brief, there is a requirement of a law. And how law should be framed? I gave you the example of right to education, right to information, and right to public service, and senior citizens' welfare. Let us go by these four aspects. The four are very good public policies emerged out of the problem that senior citizens are not being taken care of by the children. They grab their property, but they don't look into their welfare, one problem. Second problem, children are not sent to school because they are used to make small money, which is detrimental to their future. And in that process, they don't send the children to school unless government compels the parents to send these children to school and provides attraction in the school like midday meal and free distribution of textbooks and notebooks. People may not come because parents cannot afford to send the children to the schools. Problem again, policy, problem, policy, suggestions. Entire thing is called policy brief. Now, to make a private school to allocate 25% of seats to children of that locality, for which money will be reimbursed by the government of a particular state, you need a legislation. To prohibit the parents from sending their children to work, you need a legislative provision. To say that everybody has compulsory to at least to send their children to schools, there should be a provision in the law. Now, the cabinet approved the policy, but law is needed. Then who will prepare the legislative draft? We will hear the word bill of 1953, bill of 1955, or a bill of 2019. What is this bill? Bill is a legislative draft to be placed before the parliament or legislative assembly, and if the bill is approved, it will become a legislation. So, who will prepare the bill? Now, we always say legislation makes law. You tell me whether legislation 445 MPs, 545 MPs, will they sit and draft a legislation? Have you ever heard of that being done? No. 545 MPs discuss the legislation. They will question certain provisions, they will approve certain provisions, and ultimately a legislation is passed by them. That means they approve. If they want to approve, who has to prepare the law? Is it MPs and MLAs? No. It is Department of Law. And do you think Department of Law can draft everything under the earth and under the sky? No. They have to take help of drafting committees. And drafting committee will formulate a draft. And it will put to consultation of the people, and people will send their opinions, and a group of people, either academician from the law university or social workers or the persons who are working on the rights of children or rights of women or rights of senior citizens, they will all combine, they will share their experience, and they will evolve a right first of all. Now, what does the law contain? Law contains first title, second definitions, and these definitions are called interpretation provisions, expressions which are used in the legislation. Suppose you want to say every child will get an education. You have to define who is the child. Second definition is what is education. Third definition is who is the authority. Fourth definition is what is explanation given to so and so. So, various terms that you come across in your implementation of the policy will be explained in the form of definitions in the definitions clause. Section first will be the name of the enactment. Section two will be the extent of that enactment. That means, will it cover Telangana or Andhra Pradesh or Southern India or whole of India? You write that. Third section is definitions class. Fourth section is right. You have to define the right. What is the, for example, every child has a right to free and compulsory education is a right as prescribed. Then section five or six, they explain what are the exceptions. Under what exceptional clauses you can find, okay, you don't send, it's okay, but there is no such possibility at all. And then you prescribe the duties, First, title, extent of application, definitions, rights prescribed, defined, and then duties prescribed, and then authority to implement that right and duty, and then penalties if the duty is not performed and if right is violated, and then other miscellaneous provisions of expenditure and other activities of the public policy which is evolved by the cabinet on a particular issue. So, a legislative draft provides forcibility, enforceability or force of law, force of implementations, guarantee of implementations to those rights which are defined and the duties which are supposed to be performed by the authorities is prescribed. For example, right to information. In fact, railway timetable has to be prepared and given by the railway department. If it doesn't give, you file an application. Please, I want to have a copy of timetable of trains that come and go in so and so railway station. If he files a petition, you have to give it on your own, but you are not given, so he is asking, give it. So, what it contains? It contains a right to seek that information, duty to give that information, and an authority to enforce that information, like information commissioner. And thirdly, if you don't give the information, impose 25,000 rupees penalty. So, these are the essential components of legislation draft. And legislation draft provides an opportunity for the policy makers, stakeholders and the people in general to be consulted. Their experience will be taken into account and draft will be improved, approved, amended, corrected, added, removed, edited, punctuation added, exceptions added and so on and so forth. Then ultimately a bill will be finalized and that will be again considered by the parliament or the legislature. Sometimes legislature develops new doubts. They say, no, it is not comprehensively treated. Please send it to a select committee. Select committee means a small committee in which some of the members of Rajya Sabha and some of the members of Lok Sabha are selected and a chairman will be appointed and that committee will be called generally select committee. And if you have a parliamentary standing committee of a particular department, they will also consider the deficiencies and efficiencies of a bill and they give a report, they suggest some changes and that will be the final draft of bill which embodies the public policy which emerged out of a problem, approved as a policy by the cabinet and then referred to the legislature to formulate a draft. Draft is vetted by the parliamentary standing committee and sometimes select committee, joint select committee also considers the provisions of that legislation and it will be put before the legislature for passing. While passing also, members are free to offer amendments and if amendments are approved, each amendment will be taken up for approval and if it is approved by the majority, it is incorporated in the legislation and a final bill becomes enactment when it is passed by both the houses of parliament and then approved by the President of India, who is expected to affix his assent to it. And that is the legislation enactment. So, legislation and an enactment is preceded by a draft, which is called a bill. And bill is finally approved by the parliamentary standing committee and then passed by the legislature. Prior to that, it is in the form of a cabinet decision. And prior to that, it is a policy brief. And before the policy brief, it is called policy problem statement. So, from problem statement to enactment of legislation, the policy takes into different forms and ultimately you will find legislation available to be enforced and it has to be publicized properly. People should know what are their rights under this legislation. People should know where to go and file a complaint or a petition that his so-and-so right is violated and then there must be an authority who will enforce the right of the people and duty of the public authority. And if that authority doesn't act properly, there shall be a provision of appeal, review or revision. And after that, your right will be called that it is enforceable and the protection is guaranteed. This is the process of public policy becoming an enforceable legislation in the legislature. In the process, the two institutions are involved, two estates are involved. One is executive, the other is legislature. Before the executive and legislature complete their task, it has to be prepared as a brief by the people in general, supported by the government machinery. And then once this legislation is passed and when it is being implemented, if you come across the possibility of a conflict between the provision of law and with any other principle of constitution, it can be challenged before the judiciary, and judiciary, while exercising its review power, it can correct the defects of the legislation and send it back to parliament or legislative house, which public policy takes a perfect shape into an implementable enactment and enforceable right. This is how the public policy has to be drafted, legislative bill has to be prepared, and finally it has to get approved by the parliament.